गुड मॉर्निंग माय स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेकंड चैप्टर व्हिच इज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक पोटेंशियल. सो बिफोर गोइंग दिस चैप्टर सो लेट मी नो इन फर्स्ट चैप्टर व्हाट वी डिस्कस. सो एनी मैटर यू कैन टेक दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ पॉजिटिव चार्ज पार्टिकल एज वेल एज नेगेटिव चार्ज पार्टिकल मींस एनी मैटर दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ चार्जेस पॉजिटिव चार्जेस एज वेल एज नेगेटिव चार्जेस. If the number of positive charges equal to the number of negative charges, the system is said to be neutral. Okay. If what happens, any one of the charges is removed from that material, so it is negative charge deficiency. That is called positive charge reporting. Means any matter you can take that consists of charges. Okay. Means charges are two types, namely positive and negative. Got it? So these positive charges produces electric field lines. Electric field lines, that is outward. If it is positive charge, the field lines are outward. Okay. If you take negative charges, the electric field lines are inward. Inward. Got it. So what do you mean by electric field line? Means these are the electric field line. It is a space around the charge, the positive charge, or this is a space around the negative charge. The space around charge or group of charge, a test charge, the test charge is the unit positive charge, feels electrostatic force, that is called electric field line. Called electric field at that point. Means the positive charge, the electric field line outward. Means that force equal to, that is Q into E, that is Q naught, that is a test charge. E is the electric field at that point. Got it. If it is our case, our test charge here, Q naught, what about force? That is electrostatic force of this charge, that is equal to Q naught, which is on the charge, that is E. If negative charge, the electric field lines are towards that charge. If positive charge, the electric field lines are away from the charge. Also keep in mind, the charges are two types, mainly positive and negative. And unlike charges attract each other. Unlike means what? Different charges. Means the opposite quantity of charges attract each other. And the same quantity means positive, they are equal. Same kind of charges, that is like charges. Like charges repel each other and like charges attract each other. Also, you can take negative charges, the negative charges also repel each other. Got it? So, by knowing these terms, they are repel, they are attract. So each charge produces a force on other charge. This charge produces force on test charge, nothing but electric field. If both the charges interact, so this will, the what happens, force exerts this charge. So the electric field starts from positive, ends on negative. Keep in mind, the electric field starts from positive, ends on a terminate on negative charge. Always start from positive. Whatever it is, they are radially towards the negative charge. This is the direction of electric field. Direction of electric field is a start from positive, ends on a negative. Means in first charge, what we have? A charge. Okay, the charge produces electric field. Electric field starts from positive, ends on a negative. When I place charge on this electric field. These charges produce electric field line. The charge is placed on electric field line. So this electric field line exerts force on this charge. Due to that force, the charge starts moving. Means if a negative charge attracted by positive charge. Okay, the charge in the field line experiences force. When it experiences force, it will displaces from one point to another point. Displaces a distance S. The displaces a distance S. That is force into displacement, as you know that is work done. means there will be a work done on that charge. That work done is a kind of potential. Kind of a potential. Let me discuss what is mean by a potential. So before going potential, you should remember what is force. Okay, that Coulomb force. Okay, wherever we have two charges, one positive charge and positive charge, distance is r and is a Q1 charge, a Q2 charge. The force of repulsion here, but force of attraction. What is Coulomb's law? It's equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 into Q2 divided by distance r square. Means the force of attraction or repulsion between two charges directly proportional to the product of their charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. That is called a Coulomb's law. Okay, this we have to remember Coulomb's law formula. Also we have one more, the force relation, that is Q into E, which is the force experienced by the test charge. Test charge, and here I am going to use the symbol Q0. Okay, E being the electric field. Wherever you write vector here, you have to write a vector here also. This is the relation between force and electric field. Okay, by doing this, what do you mean by electrostatic potential? Keep in mind, if you have positive charges, the electric field lengths are outward. If it is negative charges, electric field lengths are towards. If it is opposite kind of charges, unlike charges, attract each other. If it is same kind of charges, repel each other. Like magnet. When we have a north pole and we have a north pole, when we bring near together, they are repel each other because they are same kind. When we have a south pole of the bar magnet and north pole of the bar magnet, bring near together, or they are attract each other. Means same kind of repel, like same kind of charges repel each other, opposite kind of charges attract each other. Okay, so this is we have the property of charges. After knowing this, let's begin. What do you mean by electrostatic potential? So before going electrostatic potential, so let's begin. What do you mean by potential difference? Electrostatic potential difference. As we know that the electric field line starts from positive ends on a negative. Okay, this is the electric field line. So there are n number of electric field line which is comes out of the positive charge. Where are positive charge, the electric field line, they are always outward. But I take any one of the electric field line. So one of the electric field line here. Okay, so let's take this is the electric field line. I am going to put a charge. This is called a test charge. Test charge means we are going to feel electrostatic force of this charge. How much force which will exert on this charge? Okay, that is called a test charge. That is called a unit positive charge. Unit positive charge also you can call. Okay, that is equal to plus 1. It is for plus charge. It is charge I am going to take Q, or you can use small letter, capital letter. I am going to use the capital letter. Okay. This is test charge, which is placed along the direction, means in the line joining points, in the line of electric field line of this charge. Okay. When I place a charge, what happens? This is positive charge. This is positive charge. What happens? They repel each other. So this source charge exert force on a test charge. At what amount? This is the force. That is electrostatic force. Which charge? On this charge, that is Q1. At what amount of electric field line? Electric field? This is this amount. Okay, so means you are right. What happens? exert force on it. Now I'm going to bring this towards those charges. Okay, this is the electric field line. Means the terminate at infinite distance. Terminate means what? Ends. The electric field line always. Okay, the longer distance, acting at longer distance. So what I'm going to do? These positive charges, this is also unit positive charge, they are equal to each other. Means this will exert force on this charge. What I'm going to do? I'm going to bring this unit positive charge towards source charge. This will repel each other. What I need? I need external force. Okay, let's say I'm going to bring this from A to B. A to B. At what distance? That distance I'm going to take is dr. Okay, I'm going to bring from A to B. Okay, the work done is that is what a force here. At what amount of force? That is external force. I need to write that. That I'm going to write F external force. So, when you apply external force, if external force is equal to the electrostatic force, then you can bring the charge from A to B. If this force, less than this force, we cannot bring this. And external force is equal to the electrostatic force, then you can bring the net force equal to zero, then you can bring the charge from A to B or towards this source charge. Means the force into displacement. That is work done. Means we don't work on that charge, then you can bring the charge towards the test charge towards source charge. Means the work done bringing, I will go to charge from one point to another point. Okay, what is electrostatic potential difference? Simply you can write the work done, that is A to B, that is equal to A to B or B to A. To B. That is what we have, F external into displacement to dr. So as we know that this force is equal to this force, that is F external force is equal to F into E. What is that E? That is equal to minus Q naught into F E. Not into F E. Got it. But keep in mind, this electric field line away from this charge, but external force, this force which is opposite to the external force. These two are equal and opposite. Okay, or you can take dot product here. But it becomes always okay. Then what happens? This is W equal to, then integration from A to B, that is minus Q naught into dr. Okay, take this side AB, WAB, take this side, that is Q naught equal to minus of A to B, E into dr. Means this will represent electric intensity at this position A to B. Okay, at a distance dr. Okay, what we have? Work done by charge. Okay, work done on this charge here is equal to potential difference from these two points. Okay, this is the energy at this position UA, this is UB. Got it? So just write, or you can write UA, this is UB. Difference of these two, that will use work done. Okay, work done. Or you can write directly, so that is potential, that is VB minus VA. Sorry, you just write work done. VB minus VB. Because higher minus lower, higher potential minus lower potential, VBA. Okay, that is equal to minus of this VB into dr. That is, compare this to, that is vb dx dot dot q naught equal to vb minus v. This is potential difference between two points. Okay, just define a collector. What do you mean by electrostatic potential? Okay, so what we do, the electrostatic potential between two points A and B, the electrostatic potential between two points in an electric field, the work done bringing a unit positive charge, from one point to another point. The work done bringing a unit positive charge from one point to another point against electrostatic force is called potential difference. Simply write down words. The work done bringing a unit positive charge from one point to another point against electrostatic force is called potential difference. Okay, that is Vb minus V is equal to Vwba divided by Q naught. So this much of work done is on that charge. We are going to bring from one point to another point. So after knowing this, what is the assignment of this potential difference? Assignment of potential difference is old. Capital V, because the sign is V, which is generated by cell. Or you can write a small letter old. Or you can write early. So what do you mean by 1 volt? What do you mean by 1 volt? Simply, what is that voltage? Nothing but 1 joule. Assignment of work done, 1 joule. What about charge here? 1 coulomb. So 1 by 1 equal to 1. So left hand side equal to right hand side. Okay, then they will match each other. Okay, so means that is the dimension formula. So what happens? How we are going to write 1 volt? Okay, the potential difference of 1 volt. What we have, simply whatever written in that definition is same as the volt assignment. What do you mean by 1 volt? Simply, what we have, 1 volt, that is the potential difference between two points in an electric field is said to be the potential difference between two points in an electric field is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work done is applied to bring 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point is called 1 volt. Simply, what we have, the potential difference between two points in an electric field is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule of work done is applied to bring a charge of 1 coulomb from one point to another point is called 1 volt. Got it? This is assignment of 1 volt. After knowing this, what do you mean by potential? Electrostatic potential. Simply, what do you mean by electrostatic potential? Simply, what we have, here we bring a charge from one point to another point. But in electrostatic potential, what I am going to do, I am bringing from infinite to a certain point. Means, this is initial point, this is final point. Initial point is VA. This is, I am going to write VA, this is I am going to write VB. Initial point and final point. I am going to assume that the initial point is at infinite distance. VA is at infinite distance. okay, that
W V A plus Y Q not equal to V B minus V A.
So means this is equal to infinite, that is equal to V B, or V equal to, that is equal to V B or V equal to V B A plus Y Q not. This is called potential at that point, this point, B point. I am going to define at this position potential. I am not discussing potential difference. Difference of these two, what is difference? I am going to find potential at only B point. That is called electrostatic potential. What do you mean by electrostatic potential? Means VA equal to 0 are taken. What do you mean by electrostatic potential? Simply the work done bringing, simply what we have, electrostatic potential is defined as you take. Electrostatic potential is defined as the work done bringing a unit positive charge, a work done bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to a certain point against electrostatic force. What we have, electrostatic potential is defined as the work done bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to a certain point against electrostatic force is called electrostatic potential at that point. Electrostatic potential at that point is called electrostatic potential. Got it? So after knowing this electrostatic potential, let me calculate what is the value of potential at this position, or at this position, at this position, at this position. How it depends on its path. Keep in mind, this potential does not depend on its path. Means, where it is, I need to bring this charge from here to here. So, this will exert potential on this charge. It does not depend on its path. When I place here, no, it doesn't depend on its path. Wherever it is, it acting from one point to another point. Got it? It does not depend on its path. And it is a scalar quantity, the energy. Got it? This is potential difference. Okay? What is the potential or potential difference? It is independent of its path. Okay. After knowing this, again, what is the acceleration of potential? It's same as cold. Acceleration of potential also cold. Just remember. Okay. So after knowing this, so very important derivation, that is potential due to a point charge. Due to point charge. What do you mean by electrostatic potential due to point charge? So again, simply I am going to take a charge, a positive or negative charges. Just take a positive charge Q, which is placed at a point Q. Just right. Let consider a charge Q, positive charge, charge Q placed at a point O in vacuum or in free space. In a free space. Then, in that part, this is the part of the electric field of this charge. This is the electric field. Got it? Select P be the point at a distance. This is a distance we call. But distance r from the point O. Got it? Let's take which is placed at a point B. It positive charge unit. Positive charge which is placed at a point A. At a distance. At a distance x from the point. Got it. Therefore, here the one charge that is the Q naught that is equal to 1. Or you can keep it as this Q naught. Unit positive charge. Got it. So this is another charge Q. So we have two charges. There will be a force of attraction and repulsion between them. It was a positive charge, this is a positive charge, they repel each other. At what distance they are placed? At distance. Therefore, the force of repulsion between two charges, according to Coulomb's law, 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0. What charge? Q charge. You know, another charge is Q naught. At what distance they are placed? X distance. What you are going to write? Consider a charge Q is placed at a point O in a free space. Let P be the point at a distance R from the point O. And a unit positive charge Q naught is placed at a point A at a distance x from the point O. Therefore, electrostatic force between these charges is this function. Now, what I am going to do? I am going to bring this charge from A to B. Initially, it exerting force. This is electrostatic force. This is electrostatic force. This one. Because this will exert more force on it. What I am going to do? I am going to bring this charge by applying the external force. Okay. I am going to bring this charge towards the source charge against electrostatic force. I need a work done. At what distance is? Let's take the distance is dx from this point to this point. Means I am bringing towards this charge. I am going to apply force. This much of force. At what distance we brought here? Dx distance here. Therefore, the work done for this process is work done to bring a charge Q naught from A to B is. That is dWdt. Because the small distance we taken, that's why this is we taken above them dWdt. That is force is F external force. That's equals to F external force into distance dx. This is vector, this is vector. Then what I am going to do is the force, as I told, F external force is equal to minus of, that is electrostatic force, because the angle between them is 180 degree. Okay, they are equal and opposite. What is the F external? Nothing but Fp. Okay, minus of Fp, that is dW equal to minus of Fp. So now, this much minus the P into dx. Or we can take a dot product, that is a cos 180. Cos 180 becomes again minus 1. Take that way also. Now this right, F external into dx cos 180. That's equal to minus Fp. This one as it is, this one as it is, dx into cos theta dot product. Okay, so cos theta dot product minus 1, so minus 1 as it is, f external is what? Fp. Or you can take this way also. That is, what about Fe? That is dW equal to minus of what about Fe? 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q into Q0 divided by what is that? X square into dx. Dx. This is a small number. What I am going to do now, I am going to bring the charge, this electric field, from infinity to a certain point. This is a small work that we applied, it will displace a small distance. Now what I am going to do, I am going to bring not this distance, the distance from infinity to a certain point. Okay, because this will exert force at every point on that electric field line. Okay, here the force, here the force. As you move away from the source charge, the force goes on decreases. Means, I am going to apply the work done to bring the unit positive charge from infinity to at a distance r. I need a total work done. Therefore, the total work done bringing work done to bring unit positive charge from where to where? From infinity to at a distance r. From infinity to at a distance r. What I am going to do? Just integrate it. From where to where? Integration of dW. That is equal to integration of infinity to r. That is minus of 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0. That is q into q0 divided by x square into dx. This term, keep it as it is. Next, what I am going to do? Integration of W becomes capital W. Where? Infinity to r. R to infinity is there. Or W is just there. So look at here, minus 10 outside. These are all constants. Q naught fixed. Unit positive charge does not change. These are constant term. So all these are constant term. They never changes. So that's why they are taken outside. Minus 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0. Q into Q naught, then the remainder is infinity to r. Plus x square is there, when it comes numerator, it becomes minus x square into dx. Got it. That is equals to, W equals to, the constant term 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q into Q naught. So, integration of x raised to dx. Here I found right. X raised to n into dx equal to. What is that? X raised to n plus 1 divided by the term n plus 1. Remember this. Okay, so n means what? Simply mean. That is x raised to, what is that n? N number. N means minus 2 plus 1. Okay, n means here n minus 2 plus 1 plus 1. All divided by whatever we have minus 2 plus 1. Lower limit infinity, upper limit r. That is equals to W equals to minus 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q into Q naught. What is that? That is x raised to minus 1 divided by minus 1. So minus 1 infinity to r. Got this. Simply that is W equals to constant term as it is minus 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q into Q naught. What is that? Minus minus cancel. Minus minus cancel here. So minus 1 when it comes denominator 1 divided by x. Sir, no, x is minus 1. Denominator, so 1 divided by x, infinity to r. That is equals to, apply the limits, 1 divided by 4 pi, w equal to 1 divided by
4 pi epsilon 0 q into q naught upper limit 1 divided by r minus 1 divided by t field. Instead of x you have write 1 by r minus of 1 by infinity. So 1 by infinity is always 0 as well. That is equal to w equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 q into q naught divided by r. So take this side, w by q naught equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by r. What is that? The definition of electrostatic potential. What is that? W by q naught means potential. V means by definition potential, that is W by q equal to V, that is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by r. This is very important question, you just remember. What happens? Look at here. The potential is the energy. If charge increases, what our potential increases. If distance increases, the potential is decreases. Means that potential inversely proportional to the distance. Got it? What about electric field? Electric field inversely proportional to the aspect. Got it? The difference between electric field and potential. Force also same. Got it? So this is the potential due to point charge. Electric potential due to point charge. They will ask questions in final question. Derive an expression for electrostatic potential due to point charge in an isolated system. Isolated means what? It is a closed system. Means nothing but free space. But so this is about the electrostatic potential due to a point charge. Okay, thank you.
Do I get it right?